we are smack in the middle of our big story, a trifecta of problems. It is really hot, it is really windy, and it is really dry. You might be wondering, but Dan, dude, it's fire season. It always gets hot, dry, and windy at some point, and you're correct. It does, but not like this. I'd try to explain, but I'd do a bad job. Matt won't, though. Matt, you have been calling this a historic wind event. Historic, how exactly?
We only see this setup, this particular situation where we're getting really strong east wind while it's hot like this, still summer, early September, maybe 2-3 times a century, Dan. That's why it's historic. Now, if this was, say, November, December, January, February, we'd be like, yeah, it's winter, we get strong east winds like this. But this is unusual for this early in the year. That's why it is historic. I want to take you outside right now and show you this scene from our Rose City Skycam. I mean, it looks, let me just say, it looks hellish out there right now with the sun through that smoky sky. Visibility super low, as you can well imagine, and the wind is blowing it all around. It's a weird scene. It's a weird feeling because we've got the smoke. We've got the wind now at 36 miles an hour out of the Portland airport, and yet the air is really dry. The humidity is only 20%. All of those combinations, though, why the fire danger is so extreme. Now, I just got this video in from Pendleton where they've been dealing with dust storms and visibility. You think ours is bad? Theirs has been below a quarter of a mile several times this afternoon. Connie Maycumber sending in this video with winds well over 30 miles an hour in the Pendleton area. Here are some of the more extreme gusts that we've had so far. Rattlesnake Ridge is up in southeast Washington, had a gust of 90 miles an hour. It's a very exposed location. They get extreme winds like that. But Umatilla, Oregon, 50. The Dalles, 40. Maryhill, a gust of 48. Goldendale, a gust of 38 miles an hour. So it is already really ramped up on the east side. Look at that. Pendleton now sustained winds at 40, now down to 35. In Portland, those sustained winds at 36 miles an hour. So we look at this. This is our hour-by-hour wind forecast for the gusts through the next 7 hours. And from 9 o'clock on, all the gusts are over 40 miles an hour. And if I were to extend that graph till 5, 6 a.m., they'd still all be over 40 miles an hour. And some places, like the West Hills and near the Gorge, will get gusts in the 60 to 65 mile an hour range. Look at this. Gusts over 50 miles an hour at the coast. Out of the east, gusts near 50 miles an hour in Portland, Cascade Locks 53, and all that purple area may see gusts well over 50 miles an hour. Parts of the Cascades will get some gusts in the 75 to 80 mile an hour range tonight, which is why the fire danger is so extreme. So those strong east winds, I know they punched through in the last hour or so, they will continue to increase. There are your gusts, as I said, 55 to 65 in the windier spots. Down trees and power outages, Dan, that's what we're likely going to be hearing about more and more as we go through the evening hours. So, couple things. This is not a night to have a barbecue. Anything that throws a spark, just forget about it right now with these strong winds. The air quality is bad, so you might want to roll up the window, keep the windows closed in your house, and we'll just have to get through this before those winds ease later in the day tomorrow. Back to you.
That picture you showed of the city, I don't know if we have that again to pop it up real quick, but it almost doesn't look like Portland. You're right. It does look like a kind of a hellish landscape. What does this tell us about this season or looking down the next couple of weeks or months when it comes to fire danger, wind? Is this just a single event or does this paint a bigger picture?
No, it's a good question. Right now, this is just a single event. We're getting extremely cold air pouring down into the northern Rockies. They're going to get snow. That is why we're getting this strong wind, because we still have all this very warm to hot air here along the West Coast. But this is more typical, to be honest with you, of a California-type situation where they get those strong winds. And it's similar to what caused the Camp Fire that destroyed Paradise, California, some of the wine area fires, even the Oakland Hills fire. That was all later in the year. That was like an October event. This type of pattern is more typical for October. So really, I would classify this as a one-off. I mean, weather does extreme and weird things. This is one of them.
Yeah, let's be responsible. Like you said, no barbecues tonight, nothing that's going to cause a spark. And let's get through this thing, hopefully, without any fire danger whatsoever.
Exactly.
Thank you. Matt, appreciate it.